Applications rely on the operating system. So what does it really do for you? First of all, as I said before, the hardware is actually not very easy to use if you had to use it directly. If you wanted to program your applications and had to work with the hardware directly, it's going to be infinitely more complex. It may already be hard, but it's going to be much harder. So what the operating system does is that it creates easier to use and high level abstractions for the resources that we have that the hardware provides. For example, we know that data that must be persistent is stored on the disk, in disk blocks. Well, we actually don't directly work with disk blocks and keep track of where on disk a certain piece of information may be. We have things called files. Think of file as a high level, or we're going to talk about virtual resources that are created or supported by the operating system and made available to you. So these high-level abstractions that we can use to access more user-friendly resources in some way make it easier for us to write our applications or build our applications that are going to run on this computer system. Now, the resources that we're going to provide, the high-level resources the operating system makes available to the applications, well, they're going to be implemented using the real physical resources that we have that the hardware provides to us. The resources, the physical resources, are going to be shared across these different applications. Obviously, when you have that kind of sharing, we need to access those resources in a controlled fashion. So the hardware resources are actually managed by the operating system, and access to those is going to be controlled via it as well. And that actually is one of the fundamental reasons why operating systems have such an important role to play when it comes to protecting resources and securing access to them. The last thing that is really interesting, and we're going to spend a good bit of time on that, is although different applications or different processes going to run on the same system and share the resources we have, the physical resources that we have between them, but the operating system sort of makes each process believe as if it's the only one running. And it's able to do that by providing what we call isolation between these different processes. In some sense, one process or one application does not need to be aware of another application unless it explicitly decides to interact with it. It's sharing these physical resources, but think about the operating system making sure that what is being used by one application doesn't get used by somebody else or another process or another application. So having this isolation, sort of giving each application sort of the feeling that it is the only one running. We should say that if they share, of course, not each process has all the resources, so there may be some performance implications. But if you don't worry about performance, basically, each process can believe as if it has the resources and the computer to itself. So the operating system is actually going to create this isolation between these different applications, which is really important because applications may not trust each other. And if they don't trust each other, they don't want any sort of interference from other processes that are not trusted by them. So this isolation, is the operating system provided isolation, is actually going to guarantee to us that a process doesn't have to worry about other processes or other applications that may be there in the system.